हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग सर.
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. हाउ आर यू?
आई एम डूइंग गुड सर, थैंक यू. हाउ आर यू?
आई एम आल्सो गुड.
हेलो सर, गुड मॉर्निंग.
गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू?
ऑल गुड सर, हाउ अबाउट यू?
आई एम आल्सो गुड.
नाइस.
So Adia, how is the climate at your place?
Yeah, it's kind of cloudy.
Cloudy. Okay.
Yeah.
So you are living in Uttarakhand?
No, I am in Indore, Madhya Pradesh.
Indore. Okay. So it's raining there?
Yeah. It's like basically 1 week. Last 1 week was kind of hot, and then now again it's raining.
Okay. Indore is near to Mumbai?
No, it's like 600 kilometers.
Oh, okay.
One night journey. Yeah.
Okay. Let's start, okay?
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So today our topic is related with the auto scaling, okay? So is that my screen visible to all of you?
Yep.
Okay. So our today's topic is virtual machine skill set. And the virtual machine skill set is a topic which is related with the auto scaling skill set. Virtual machine skill set we are calling as auto scaling. So auto scaling is a general term, but in the Microsoft Azure environment, we are calling as the same thing we are calling as virtual machine skill set. So guys, what is your opinion about auto scaling? Any opinion do you have?
I think it's the same thing which you have already shared with us, that whenever there is high traffic, in that case, this auto scaling work. We create more servers accordingly and then balance the load.
Yes. So scale in will be happen, scale out will be happen. Scale out means adding the new extra server, and scale out means adding the new servers. Keep on adding. If the traffic will be increase, if the load will be increase, and removing the extra servers automatically if the traffic will be or the load will be down. That's the purpose of the auto scaling, right? So auto scaling will
I can't hear you.
Yeah, even I can't hear, sir.
All right, yes. I thought I am the only one.
Yeah.
Adi, congrats, you are the host now.
Hello. Hello. Am I audible to you?
Yes, I can hear you.
Yeah, actually, power fluctuation happened. So that's why the internet was disturbed. Okay. So, auto scaling is a topic which is related with the adding the extra new servers. When the load will be increased on the hardware, like the CPU, when the CPU load will be increased, it will add the new extra servers. When the load will be decreased, then automatically the extra servers will be deleted, right? So let's create a scenario. The scenario is that the company name is www.flipkart.com. So everybody know about the flipkart.com is an e-commerce company, e-commerce website, which is selling the products online. So e-commerce company have this flipkart.com have two servers, server number one, server number two. So this company have total number of servers two, and these two servers are associated with the load balancer. Maybe the traffic one to come through the load balancer, incoming traffic. This is a load balancer. So, and this load balancer will receive the traffic. Let's say the traffic, the load balancer public IP address is 54.0.0.4. And there is an ISP. So ISP is the internet service provider. It's a provider of the internet connection. So every city, every state, every country may have the different ISPs, right? So somewhere you can see the Tata is the sky ISP Tata telecommunication. Somewhere you can find the Airtel telecommunication is providing the internet connection to the people or the industry. Somewhere you can find the Jio fiber optic cable, which is providing the internet connection to the people and the industry, right? So ISP is a provider of the internet connection. So the people are using the different gadgets. Somebody is using the laptop, somebody is using the desktop computer, somebody is using the tablets, somebody is using the mobile phones. So they are doing the shopping, the people are doing the shopping. So when that people do the shopping, they place the order, and through the internet the order request will go to the load balancer, and the load balancer will send the request towards the servers, any of the servers, right? If the first user will send the request will be sent to the first server. If the second user will send the request will be sent to the second server. If the third user will send the request, the third user request will go to the first server. If the fourth user request will send the fourth user request will go to the second server. So it is balanced. The load balancer is receiving the request from the people through the internet. So incoming traffic is coming through the internet, and the load balancer is distributing one by one towards among both of the servers, right? If the first user is sending the request, and the request is coming for the first user through the internet, the load balancer will give it to the server number one. If the second user request is coming, the load balancer will distribute to the server number two. If the third user request is coming, the load balancer will distribute to the server number three. If the fourth user request is coming through the internet, which is an incoming request, and the load balancer will distribute to the server number two. So like this way, the load balancer equally distributing the load towards both of the servers. Okay, so this is the role of the load balancer: balance the load, distribute the load towards all the servers which are associated with the load balancer. So we are assuming another scenario which is associated with the same scenario. Both of the servers having a maximum load handling capacity that if both of the servers will receive 100% of the CPU utilization, right? When both of the servers can handle the load incoming request at a time, we can say both of the servers are working at the 100% of the capacity CPU utilization when they are receiving the 10 lakh user request. Okay. So when they are receiving the 10 lakh user request, it means to say that their capacity is full. Both of the servers are working at the 100% of the capacity. Both of the servers' CPU utilization is 100%. So what if the load will be increased more than the 10 lakh? It especially happened during the sale offers. You know, Flipkart.com. Flipkart is a company which is an online website which is selling the products online. So time to time, the Flipkart company introduces the sale offers during the festival time periods, right? Festival time periods like Diwali time period, Diwali festival, right? During the Christmas, during the New Year, right? So during the many festivals are there, during Eid, okay? So time to time, Flipkart.com introduces the many offers, sale offers, discount offers, right? So during the sale offers, okay? During this sale offers, the company gives 50% discount, 30% discount, 10% discount, 20% discount. So different types, different discounts on different products the company is giving during this sale time period, right? During this sale time period, because the company's intention is to promote the business more and more, and get the profit more and more, attract the customers more and more by giving the sale offers, right? 50%. If the laptop price is 60,000 rupees, during this sale offer, if the discount is 50%, then the same laptop will be available for the customer in 30,000 rupees, right? So instead of 60,000 rupees, the customer have to pay 30,000 rupees. It's a good deal for the customers. So that's why during the sale offers, the customer will place more and more offers, and the traffic will be definitely increased more than the 10 lakh users request, right? So the 10 lakh users request will be cross up. The request during the sale time period, it will reach up to the crores, like the 1 crore, 2 crore. So till the 10 crore, the request can go. Okay. So guys, the CPU capacity is maximum 100%. When 100%, it will reach up to the 100% when the traffic at a particular time, on a particular time period, will reach up to 10 lakh user requests. So maximum handling, load handling capacity for both of the servers is 10 lakh users request. If the users request will be increased more than the 10 lakh users, then what will happen? Guys, what are the chances? What is your opinion? What will happen with this?
Server will get crashed.
The servers will get crashed, right? Due to the overload, the servers, both of the servers will crash. Okay. So this is the reason why in the previous years, like the 10 years before, 11 years before, 12 years, 20 years, 15 years before, usually we were facing the problem, the site is down, the server is down, the site is down, the site is not opening due to the overload. That is the reason was that the unexpected extra traffic comes more than the load handling capacity of the servers. That's why the server got crashed. So that's why in our previous, without, when the cloud was not in existence, proper cloud was not in existence. So all of the servers, due to the extra load on the servers, the server were crashing, right? But after the introduction of the cloud computing, so all these problems got sorted out, because cloud came with the concept of auto scaling, right? If any extra load will become, the auto scaling concept, auto scaling feature will automatically create the extra servers, and the load will be divided towards all the servers, right? So what the auto scaling will do, if you will configure the auto scaling feature, the auto scaling feature will create extra servers, will add new servers, right? But how the auto scaling feature will add the new servers, for that purpose we have to create a threshold during the configuration of the auto scaling. Threshold in the sense, when the CPU, we can set a threshold during the configuration of the auto scaling, when the CPU utilization, when the CPU utilization will reach greater than 50%, then automatically one server should get created. Okay, then the load will be divided among the three servers. Two servers are the minimum servers, server one, server two, and the third server means the server three will get automatically created. So this adding the new server, we are calling as scale out. So adding the new servers or deleting the existing server, we are calling as horizontal scaling. We are calling as horizontal scaling, horizontal scaling. Okay. So adding the new server, we are calling as scale out. So it will keep on adding the new servers let's say the 50%, the load will come on 50% on both of the servers, then automatically as per the threshold, when the threshold will set the send the alarm, will trigger the alarm, right? And this alarm will be triggered and automatically the new server will get created. Now the load will be divided among the three servers instead of the two servers. If again the CPU utilization will reach up to the 50%, greater than this 50%, then again one new server will get created. Now the new load will be divided among the four servers, server one, server two, server three, server four, instead of the three servers, right? Again, when the CPU load will reach up to greater than 50%, if it will increase, the CPU utilization or the CPU load will reach greater than 50%, then 50%, I mean to say that 50% of this one, 50 means total load, 50% of all servers, not only the single server, 50% of all the four servers, total server which are running in existence. So when the load will be increased greater than 50% of all the four servers, and again the new extra server will get created with the same specification, same website, same everything. So this will keep on increasing again and again, keep on increasing again and again. So there will be no chances that the server is down, right? There will be no chances that server is down. So this is the beauty of the auto scaling. So it will never let your website to be down, and website will be continuously highly available towards all the customers, and the people will continuously do the shopping, right? People will not feel that any server is going to be extra ad. People will see the website. That website at day and night every time will be available for the people. But in the back end, what is going to be happen? If the load increases more than the 50%, a new server adds. If again the load increases more than the 50% towards including the extra server, then again one new extra server got added, right? It will keep on adding the extra new servers until the load will reach less than the 50%, will goes gradually less than the 50%. So this sale offer will work for, we are assuming this sale offers is for the 3 days. 3 days sale. So guys, what will happen after the 3 days? Let's say total number of servers created automatically, total servers including adding the new server reach up to the level of 10 servers, right? 10 servers. So this sale offers will work for the 3 days, but after the 3 days, when the traffic will come to the normal traffic, and the traffic will be in the normal time period after normal days, after the 3 days, it will come in the strength of 2 lakh request, 3 lakh request, 4 lakh request, 5 lakh request. So after the 3 days, the same auto scaling feature, when the load will be reduced, it will start deleting the extra servers. It will start deleting the extra server. It's good, right? Because running the extra server when there is no traffic, it's not good for the billing point of view. Why we should pay the bill if the load is not there? Why we will pay the extras? Why we will keep the extra servers if the load is not there, right? When the load is more, keeping the extra server, it gives us the value, it's worth. But after the 3 days, till the 3 days, okay, the company earned a good profit. The company sold a lot of products online and people purchased a lot of products online. Till 3 days, the company got full benefit. Company did a lot of sales. But what after the 3 days? After the 3 days, keeping the extra server, it's not beneficial for the company, because the company is paying for the as per the pay-as-you-go pricing model. If company is keeping the eight extra servers, then the two servers are enough after the 3 days for handling the load. Why the company should keep the eight extra servers which were created during the sale time period? So after the 3 days, when there is a normal time period of the normal traffic is coming from the customer for the purchase of the products after the 3 days, and the two servers are enough to handle the incoming load, which is coming from the outside, then automatically that 8 extra servers will be deleted. So this is a benefit of the auto scaling, and the auto scaling in the Microsoft Azure environment, we are calling as virtual machine skill set. Just a name difference is there. So auto scaling, we in the AWS, we are also calling as auto scaling, but behind the virtual machine skill set, there is an auto scaling. Virtual machine skill set is also an auto scaling. Cleared, guys?
Sir, I have a question here.
Yes.
So let's suppose we have these two servers. All right, and we have an external load balancer here.
Yes.
And during the sale days, if like 8 more servers get added by auto scaling, in that meantime, do we need to parallelly add those server or our external load balancer, or it will get automatically added?
It will get automatically added.
Okay.
It will get automatically associated with the load balancer even.
Okay, so no manual effort need to be done.
No manual, nothing is manual. So that's why auto.
Hmm.
Auto means automation. Okay. So right. Nobody will keep an eye on the load balancer that, okay, which one is down? Okay. The load is increasing or not? Load is increasing or not? Otherwise, there is no use, right? So it will be automatically added, associated with the load balancer, external load balancer. Okay. Clear?
All right. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Everybody, other people, Adi, Aman, Anvil.
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Okay.
Yes.
So, how to configure the virtual machine skill set? Step by step, let's see. This was the concept of the virtual machine skill set, and the virtual machine skill set. In directive we are calling as auto scaling, right? So how we configure, let's see with the help of a practical real-time scenario. So let's go to the portal first. portal.azure.com. So, guys, what we are going to do, we are creating some virtual machines. We will create 2 virtual machines. Okay, instead of creating the individually virtual machine, what we are going to do, there's an option called as virtual machine skill set at the left-hand side. If you will not find this option, virtual machine skill set, you can go to the search, and there you can type skill set. Skill set. So when you will type skill set under the services, you will find there's an option called as virtual machine skill set. So click over the virtual machine skill set. So whenever you will click over the virtual machine skill set, virtual machine skill set dashboard will be available in front of you on the screen. Now click over create. Resource group, we can create a new resource group. I am creating a new resource group with the name test. Click over OK. And the virtual machine skill set name I am giving here, my skill set. It's up to you what name you would like to assign for while creating the new skill set. It's up to you. The name assignment is your choice. So my skill set, I am giving the name. So region, I am selecting here Central US. Availability zone, I can take the availability zone three availability zone, 1, 2, 3. And here, leave everything as it is. Then I would like to take the image of the server as Windows Server 2016. Size, it's coming. Let's wait. Yes, so size is B1S. And if I will run a single virtual machine for the whole month, then it will cost me 657.41. So username I am giving here, Azure, and the password I will assign here, capital P A S S W O R D 123. Confirm the password, capital P A S S W O R D 123. Scroll down, click over next. Under the disk, we will leave everything as it is. Click over next. Under the networking. So you can see there is one option, test VNet. It's again going to be created automatically. This VNet is going to be created. So click over edit. So here in this network interface, this is the network interface. So this network interface by default, it is not associated with the public IP address. So that's why public IP address is disabled. But you have to access the EC2 instances, which will get automatically created from the outside of the cloud. And you people are outside of the cloud. So if you people are outside of the cloud, then how do you access? You will access with the help of the public IP address. Right, so you have to enable the public IP address if you want to access these servers from the outside, from your laptop. So make it enable. And here, public inbound port rules. So the traffic, the incoming traffic should come from which port that you can select it. You can select HTTP, you can select HTTPS, you can select RDP. So I selected three ports, HTTP, HTTPS, RDP. So everything as it is, click over OK. And you can select this one. So this you already selected, right? Now there's an option called as load balancer, use a load balancer. You can place this virtual skill set in the backend pool of an existing Azure load balancing solution. So use a load balancer. I will choose the load balancer. It will automatically create a new load balancer with the name MyScaleSetLB, right? And backend pool will get automatically created with the name BEPool, right? So I will continue with the same option. So click on next. So guys, I have not created a load balancer. I have not provisioned a load balancer before creating the skill set. So that's why I am creating the load balancer at the time of the creation of the skill set, right? If I have already created the load balancer before, provisioned a load balancer before creating the skill set, then I can choose the existing load balancer. But I have not yet created any existing load balancer. I have not provisioned any existing load balancer before the creation of the skill set. So that's why I am going to create a new load balancer. It will get created. So click over next, scaling. So under the scaling, you'll find two options. You want to scale it manually. You want to scale it custom automatically. So I don't want the manual. I want the automated. So click over custom. So minimum number of instances, virtual machines you can keep, you want to keep. So I want to keep minimum at least two servers. Okay, I want to keep minimum at least one server, minimum, right? Minimum, okay, let's keep it two. I want to keep minimum only minimum two servers, and maximum number of servers I want to keep it five. Maximum servers means if extra load will come to your server on the CPU, then it will keep on adding the new servers. It will keep on adding and increasing the new servers, but up to the maximum limit of five. So you have to specify the limit. You have to guess the limit if extra load will come during even the for the 3 days sale time period. So it will not be increased more than the five server, or you can specify 10, you can specify 15. It's up to you. How many number of servers you are specifying, it's up to you, right? So you have to get an idea, okay? Why we are specifying the maximum limit? Maybe the reason is that maybe somebody created a script that will keep on increasing the load on your server, right? In this way, your server will be add on. It will keep on creating extra servers continuously. Maybe due to the bug, the load will be continuously increased on the CPU. And it will increase the load. Then in this situation, the extra server will keep on increasing continuously, right? In order to avoid this kind of situation, you will set a maximum limit. Otherwise, it will reach up to the 1,000 number of server. So it will become a loss for the company, right? It was just due to the bug mistake, due to the error mistake, due to some wrong mistake. The load was increased unnecessarily, and the virtual machine skill set will keep on increasing the extra server up to the 1,000 server, 2,000 server, 3,000 servers. So it is not good. So that's why we are setting the limit. Getting clear, guys? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, minimum number of servers you can decide, maximum number of servers you can decide, and scale out. So scale out, after what percentage of the CPU utilization the new server should be added. I want this after the 50%. When the CPU utilization will reach up to 50%, will trigger 50%, automatically one new server should get created. You can increase by two also, you can increase by three also, you can increase by four also, but I'm giving here increment of the new server. I would like to give it one. Duration in minutes, here it is mentioned 10. What does it mean? It means to say that when the load on the CPU will continuously remain till 10 minutes, 50%. Till 10 minutes, 50% or more, right? Then after the 10 minutes, a new virtual machine will get created. After the 10 minutes, it will monitor. If till 10 minutes time period, during the 10 minutes time period, if continuously the load on the CPU will sustain up to 50%, then only the one virtual machine will get created. If it will goes down before the 10 minutes, then the new virtual machine will not be add on. Okay, the load it will monitor up to the 10 minutes continuous. If the 10 minutes continuous load will be sustained here, then a new virtual machine will get add on or will get created. So I am reducing the time period here instead of the five minutes instead of the 10 minutes, because 10 minutes is a very big, long time period. Okay. If I will give it three, it will not accept, because the minimum time period, it is 5 minutes, and the maximum time period is 60 minutes. So I am giving here five, which is a minimum one. And number of instances will add on at the time of the more CPU utilization, more than the 50%, then on one extra server will get add on. If you want the two servers should be add on, but the CPU utilization will reach more than the 50%, then the two extra servers will get created, because we are mentioning two. But I don't want the two, I want only one. CPU utilize CPU threshold. So scaling. So this was the setting of the scale out, right? When the CPU utilization will reach more than the 50%, and it will wait for the 5 minutes. If the load is continuously, the load is getting continuously 50%, more than the 50% till 5 minutes, then the new extra virtual machine will get created. Otherwise, it will not get created. Now scaling. Scaling means deleting the extra servers. You know, I told you that after the 3 days, the load will come to the normal. At that time, the extra created virtual machine should get automatically deleted, right? So here, that setting is here, scale in. That setting is here in the form of scaling. Scaling means deleting the extra server, and scale out means adding the extra servers. So scale in setting is here. During the normal days, when the traffic is normal, or when the sale is over, after the 3 days, thus traffic will become normal. At that time, if the load will goes, CPU load will goes up to 25%, then a new extra virtual machine will get automatically deleted. You can make it two also, you can make it three also. So I'm giving here one only. So click over next. Under the management, enable with the managed storage account. Okay, I will leave everything, all the settings as it is. Next, health, everything I will leave as it is. Advance, leave everything. Tag. Now create. So deployment is in progress. So you can see here, so deployment is complete. Okay, so where we can find the virtual machines. So go to the resource. You can see there is an option called as instances under the virtual machine, my skill set. You can, one is already created, has been created and it's running. And second virtual machine, it's in the process of creation. It's updating, right? So why two virtual machines are available? Because at the time of provisioning the virtual machine skill set, the name is my skill set. We mentioned at least two minimum virtual machine is required. Okay. So that's why two virtual machines are available at the time of creation. So like this way, two virtual machines are here. So we mentioned here the two virtual machine, minimum two virtual machines should be remain always. So let's refresh it. So now you can see both of the virtual machines are provisioned successfully. Okay, my skills at 0, my skills at 2. These are the name automatically given, right? So now let's take the remote access of these virtual machines. Any one of the virtual machine. Just we required to copy the public IP address. Go to run. MSTSC. Paste the public IP address. Click on connect. Username is Azure. Password capital PASSWORD@123. Click over OK. Click over yes. You can see we got the successful remote connection of this server. So guys, this is not a real environment where the real load is coming through the internet, right? And the real load is coming here through the internet on the website or the web servers, right? So this is not the real environment, right? So how to put the artificial load. So for putting the artificial load for the testing purpose, I have one script. That script I will share with you also. That will help you for doing the same lab in your computers also, right? So that script, I will take it from my computer. Give me one moment. So this is a script. I'm going to paste it on my laptop process. But guys, don't run this script on your physical laptop. Otherwise, your physical laptop CPU utilization will reach like more than 80%, 90%, maybe 100%, right? So I will copy and paste this script in the virtual machine. So this is the virtual machine that we have created just now. So I will put the artificial load for the testing purpose on this virtual machine. I would like to test whether, if I will put the load, whether the auto scaling feature or the virtual machine skill set feature or the service will increase the new server or not. I would like to test. So I will paste this. And if you will see the load CPU utilization here on the server, we can see from here. Task manager, more details. And you can see currently the CPU utilization is 8%, 7%, right? 8%, 7%, 8% again, 10%. So this is the normal load. This is the normal load. So now I will run this script. You can see the load has been increased 99%. So it will wait till the 5 minutes it will wait, right? Continuously till the 5 minutes, if the same load will be on this virtual machine, then automatically a new virtual machine will should be scale out, should be created. So let's wait. And there's an option. Okay, where's my, okay, click over here, my skill set. Click over instances, we already there. So we need to wait for 5 minutes. So guys, let's take a short break. After the 5 minutes, we will see what is the status. Okay, guys?
Okay, sir.
Okay.
हेलो
हेलो सर।
वी आर बैक अगेन. ओके
यस
सो लोड वी हैव इंक्रीज्ड एंड लेट्स रिफ्रेश नाउ. यू कैन सी दिस इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ द ऑटो स्केलिंग. दिस इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ द वर्चुअल मशीन स्केल सेट. Automatically, it kept on increasing the new virtual machines, right? New virtual machines. So new virtual machine has been created automatically. Okay.
Sir, I have one question here.
Yeah.
Like we increase the CPU utilization at the scale set two virtual machine, right?
Two or one? One.
Yeah, I think only on one machine we increase, right? So
Keep on increasing one by one.
okay.
It doesn't mean that it will increase only one. It means one by one. If again the pressure will come, it will increase and another one. If again the pressure will be more come, then again one more create. One, 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 like that.
Let's say on one virtual machine, let's say the CPU utilization is like about 90%, like we did it. But another machine, we didn't do it. So that at that time, the CPU utilization might be like minimal, like 20% or something, right? So still, it's going to
It will
increase.
take the count of total aggregate.
Of both the initial
Yes,
virtual machines.
yes, yes. It will take the aggregate. Okay, in the backend, it will count total. Take the count of the aggregate. Total virtual machine. Whatever the total virtual machine is in the
Okay.
running process. Okay.
Okay. It's kind of thing it will average out until that time it will,
Average. Correct. Average point
create.
is coming here.
Yeah.
Average.
Till that time it will create machines until it doesn't find the load is balanced.
Yes, this is the thing. Okay.
Got it, sir. Yes.
Now I will reduce the load. I will stop the script. Then let's see what will happen. So this is the script. I will close the script. Now you can see here the load will be decrease 77%, 80%, 84%. After some moment, you will find the load will be increase, decrease 4%, 1%. Two percent, 1%. So let's wait. It will reduce the extra virtual machines automatically because there is no load. Let's wait. We have to wait 5 minutes. Waiting time period is 5. If continuously till 5 minutes the load will be sustained, the load will be sustained 25% or less than the 25%, then automatically scaling process will be start. Scaling process means automatically deletion of the extra virtual machine will be start.
Sir, does it work on hybrid environment too? Like suppose we have the servers.
No, it will not work on the hybrid environment. It will work on the cloud environment only. Oh, in the hybrid environment means physical server also will come, right?
Yeah, exactly.
So in the physical environment, everything is physical. Mm-hmm. You do the installation, it's physical also, right?
Yeah, so no connectivity should be there, right?
No. It will work only for the cloud. So that's why the people are moving towards the cloud instead of keeping their infrastructure on the physical. Because in the physical, the people usually will do the order of the more machines. Okay, I need the two physical servers. Then quotation will go. The person, the vendor will generate the bill. And through the transport, the servers will come at the company premises. Then the engineer will test the connectivity and check the hardware. Then the installation of the operating system will be start, right? Yeah. So it will, the downtime is there.
Sir, let's say in hybrid environment, we implemented the platform as a service that our application is running on the virtual machines. And there is one, let's say a data center, which is at the physical environment. So still we cannot have this scaling because our application is still on the cloud, right? So still we cannot do this feature.
That's why in the hybrid environment, auto scaling does not work. If there is a hybrid environment, that's why I'm clearly saying in the hybrid environment or the pure physical environment. In the pure physical environment, in the hybrid environment, auto scaling does not work. It works only in the cloud environment. If your resources are only in the cloud, then it will work.
So it's a benefit for the cloud environment.
It's a benefit for the cloud environment. Correct. See, deletion has been started. Because there is no load. It is automatic. It's very good, right? And it is not possible that every second the human being will keep an eye on the server, CPU, every second, right? It's a human being, right? But machine can do this. Machine can do this automation. Every time the machine can keep an eye on the CPU utilization. Wherever the CPU utilization goes down 25% or less than the 25%, it will automatically start keep on deleting the extra servers. And the billing will be also in the budget and the control, right? When the company is doing more and more sales, okay, no problem. Company don't have the worry about that because company is getting the more profit during the sale time period and the traffic is coming more and the load is coming more. No problem for creating that. So only the 3 days, the extra servers will be created. When the 3 days will be time period will be over, sale will be over, extra virtual machines will get automatically deleted. That's a good deal for the company.
So we can like put the dates too. Like for 3 days only.
No, not 3 days. Not 3 days, not 2 days, not 5 days. Mm-hmm. Means automatically it will work on the basis of the CPU. 3 days I'm telling you, estimate. It can be the 3 days, right. It can be the 4 days. But it will work on the CPU utilization.
So that means that we need to run this my virtual skill set all the time. Mm-hmm. So whenever the...
Load will be increased, virtual machine will be increased. Load will be decreased, virtual machine will be scaling. Load will be increased, scale out will be happen. Load will be decreased, scale in will be happen automatically.
If I got a chance to get interviewed on any other e-commerce site, I will definitely tell them.
Definitely, right. they will select you on a very good position, definitely. This is a very good advantage of the cloud computing. You know, now these days, there is no before, in the 10 years before, 11 years before, especially on the IRCTC website. You remember? During the reservation on the railway reservation.
CBSE board site.
Yeah, yeah. Sometimes the railway website downs. IRCTC website. But now these days, it's because of the auto-scaling feature, there is no downtime kind of thing. See, rest of the server automatically got deleted. And the two servers will be remain. This is also deleting. Now you can see only two servers are there, which are the minimum servers, right? We set in the configuration. If you click over the scaling, you can see here, instance limit is minimum 2, maximum 5, default 2. So you can change it.
Like, sir, I have one question over here. Let's say I have a virtual machine which I need to include in this skill set. So can we do it, or?
You have one virtual machine.
Let's say it's a virtual server we created, but I want to add it. Means, can we do custom thing, or it will happen over here?
Custom thing you cannot do. Okay. It will be automatic auto. You cannot add on. If you mention here one, minimum 2, then it will remain minimum 2. You cannot add the third one custom or manually, and you cannot make it 3. If it is minimum defined here 2, then it will remain at any cost, 2 will be there, minimum. You cannot add the new custom one manually. Okay, that's why the name is auto scaling, right? Auto scaling. It will maintain the minimum, whatever the minimum you set the limit. Maximum 5, default is 2. Scale out policy, scale in policy, right? So guys, this was about the auto scaling. Auto scaling means virtual machine skill set, and the virtual machine skill set is also called as auto scaling, okay? So now I would like to give one assignment to you. Here, one assignment for the home and one assignment for, okay, guys, you can do the assignment here. The same thing you have to perform here, right? So I'm going to share the script with you. So guys, script, I'm uploading the script. It's a batch file. You can download this file. Then download is done. Hello?
Yes, Adi? Downloaded.
Downloaded, right?
Downloaded. I'm downloaded.
Okay. And with? Anvin, Raghavendra?
Yes, sir, downloaded.
Downloaded, okay. So now the same exercise you have to do now as an assignment. The same now. Once it will be finished, then send me the snapshot.
Sir, I created the skill set and I'm in the instances, but I didn't find the public IP address.
Click on instance. Find the public IP address. Just share your screen.
Okay, sure. So this is my scale set. And I am on my instances. There are two instances which are created. Let me click on this one.
The reason is that you missed one step. We enabled the public IP address. By default, it is disabled. Okay. So do one thing. Go to the. Okay. So do one thing. Delete the skill set.
Okay.
Click over the VM skill set. Okay. So here, skill set, where is the name of this? Okay. Click over the VM skill set on the top.
Yes, I clicked on.
Okay, click over the home. Okay, click over the VM skill set on the top, skill sets. Yes. Select this skill set. Okay, delete option is there near to the stop. Click over there. Delete. Yes, type yes. Click over delete. Click over create. Click over the create, it will get deleted automatically after some time. Now you can proceed.
I have created, but I can't able to log in on the instances.
Okay, just wait. Next. Wait. Previous. Okay, now scroll down. Central US, slowly. Okay, click on next. Okay, click over next. Okay. So scroll down, okay. Click on edit, this pencil sign, pencil symbol. Okay, scroll down and click on inbound rules, allowing selected inbound port. So Raghav, you have done this mistake here. You did skip this step. Select HTTP, HTTPS, RDP. RDP also, okay, scroll down. Enable the public IP address. Click over enable. Now click over OK. That's OK. OK. Now select this one. Test check mark. OK. Now scroll down. Load check mark the load balancer. Scroll down. OK. Everything take as it is default. Click over next. It will create the load balancer. OK. Now you can continue. Now you can unshare also even.
Yeah, okay.
Raghav, you also can do the same thing. Adi, now you got the public IP address?
Yeah, it's creating.
Okay.
My scale sets were created. I just ran the script and now I'm waiting for 5 minutes.
Okay. So you have to wait 5 minutes at least. So you set up 10 minutes or 5 minutes?
I set up 5 minutes.
Okay. In 5 minutes, you have to wait.
So mine is done.
It's done? Okay. Just please share your screen. I will unshare my screen. Now you can share.
Is it visible?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's start creating.
Perfect. It's creating, right? So how many virtual machines minimum you set up?
One virtual machine and four another skill set machine.
Okay. The script is nice, right?
This batch file.
Yeah, batch file is nice.
We use these batch files to run SSCM patches.
It's the same? The same?
No, not file? The same. There are a few changes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. SSCM, okay. So what is the environment? Tell me about the environment. What is the setup there?
There's nothing much. Like, I was working with HCL at that time and the SSCM team will share these kind of batch files. And I need to run these files on client machines. I can run on I can transfer it through SSCM itself or by like taking remote of the machine and then run.
So at that time you was working with the HCL, right? In which branch? Which location? Hello? Hello. Raghav? Your voice is not audible.
Hello, I'm audible now?
Now you're audible. There was a...
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Then glitch.
So at that in which branch you was working before at, in HCL?
I was in moved to L1 support. Okay. L1
in Bangalore?
No, at Noida only, at Sector 126.
Noida, okay. It's a very big in Noida. HCL.
It's they itself have their own city.
Yes. Noida, they set up the many branches, many locations they have at HCL. In the sectors, 15 is also there, right? Sector 15, Sector 126, Greater Noida, and many locations they have, actually very big.
There's somewhere around 8 or 9 HCL branches on Noida only.
Mm-hmm. Oh my God, very, very big.
And then 126 is itself is that much big that all the branches can come inside it.
Oh, okay. And there is one temple is also there, right? And that place is also there, the village. The village name, you remember the name of the village, which is near Raipura. To your location? Raipur. Raipur.
That was a horrible place, I can say.
okay, how?
I spent it more than me and Aman. We both spent it more than 9 or 10 months out there.
Uh-huh.
So basically, people, students basically, who are studying at that university.
Amity University. Mm-hmm.
So every day, like, there are some kind of issues. People are fighting out there. Even the villagers are too horrible out there.
Yes.
So we somehow survived more than 8 or 9 months out there.
Okay. So you are from Karnataka?
No, from Uttarakhand.
Uttarakhand, okay. You are from Uttarakhand. Okay. So Raipura, that's Raipur village is very horrible. And almost the people, even the students and the people who are working in the companies, they are living there because that place is very, very near, right?
Yeah, that's the major reason. Although HCL is providing cabs, so people start moving to different locations then.
Yes.
Otherwise, all the students who are studying at MIT, they are staying out there only.
There only, yes. Even the rooms are, OEO rooms are very, very expensive there, right?
I can say it's like when like first we went out and we searched, we came to know that 16,000 per bed.
16,000 per bed, yes.
Without
yes,
food.
My God. Without food, see.
So how me much and expensive Aman, this is. We both were like, itne mein kaise chalega?
Yes.
Then we searched more and more. Those were the initial days. Then after that, we were used to the things.
That's like very, very expensive. Now,
right? Hello, sir. My class is done.
Are yours also done?
Yeah.
I'm stopped.
Okay. You can share your screen.
Okay, sir. So now it's visible?
Yes. So it's visible. Creating. It's creating. Yeah, it's yes. Wonderful. That's wonderful. Wonderful. It's working fine. So let's wait. Okay, let's wait. It will create how many maximum number of virtual machines?
Five,
right? Okay, when it will reach up to the 5, let's see what will happen.
Okay,
then we will stop the script.
Okay,
when it will reach up to the 5. This is very, very good concept.
Yes, sir.
So you people, are you downloading the videos time to time?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So better to download the videos. You can make it locally on your computer. So it will good, right?
Yes,
so it will good because anytime with offline also you can read that, you can watch that videos, you can do the study offline, and it will be a permanent asset. Nice. So how much time it takes usually to download the video?
Depending upon the internet speed.
correct.
So, I mean,
yes.
5 to 10 minutes.
5 to 10 minutes. Okay. I mean, how? Which plan you are using? Internet plan, and which service provider?
Sir, I am using Airtel.
Airtel,
using okay. The unlimited one.
Unlimited one. Okay. So, what speed they are giving to you?
Here in my area, the maximum speed is 16. I think it was 16.
16. Not 16 Mbps. 16.
Not 16 Mbps.
Oh.
Is that 1 Mbps? But there is some threshold. No, they break it into. The wire that they have put is around 16 something, they say 1640.
Okay.
They have got 100, right? So the 16 Mbps is maximum.
Hmm.
But we don't get 16 Mbps. We get maybe.
So maximum they mentioned it 16 Mbps, but in actual you are getting the less speed, 1 or 2
Mbps.
Right?
Yeah, not in just hardly 1 Mbps.
Oh my God! It's 1 Mbps is very very less. It's extreme less. So why don't you change the plan? It's better to change the other plan. Hathaway is also good. Hathaway,
right? Yeah.
Yeah. Hathaway is very good. You will get the 30 Mbps speed, you will get it. 30, 35.
Okay. I'll have to look. So this is there from a long time. So I didn't bother to change.
So how much they charge monthly price?
Monthly Airtel. Is some 582, including taxes.
582
582.
Okay. Yes. So Hathaway is also charging almost same 600, 700 like that. Hathaway.
Okay.
Yeah, there is no much difference. So Airtel is not giving, it means good speed in your local area.
Yeah, it is not giving good speed, sir. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
They promised us 40 Mbps infrastructure, but then they are giving 16, and that is also not
that is also not proper. So even you can get through the mobile also, you through the Jio you can get more speed than the Airtel.
Yes,
yeah, on the mobile Jio you can get 3 Mbps speed, 4 Mbps speed you can get it. Even sometime the my fiber connection doesn't work, right? Means due to the internet cable problem. Then I use my Jio connection, and the Jio connection gives me around 4 Mbps, 3 Mbps, 3.5 Mbps. That is okay. That is manageable. That's very good.
But all these people advertise 40, 100 and all, 200, 300, but nothing. You don't get anything actually.
Yes. You know, previously, 10 years before, maybe 12 years before, I worked on the KBPS speed also. You remember?
Yes, sir. Those dial-up, right?
Dial-up connection.
Yeah.
And at that time, there was the connection was the same connection for the telephone cable also, the same connection for the internet also.
Yes.
If somebody is calling to you, internet will get disconnected, right? And if you are using the internet at the same time, you cannot call, right? So at a time, one task you was able to do through the normal BSNL at that time it was working, giving this dial-up.
Yes, I was in college or school at that time. I remember some weird noise it used to make.
Yes. At that time, the cyber cafes were very, very important for us. We spent a lot of 1 hour, 2 hours in the cyber cafe for doing some, for studying something or for sending the email, something like that. And the internet was not easily available at home. then slowly awareness came, the people started getting the internet connection through the dial-up connection.
So now everybody has got internet.
Now everybody's getting the internet connection. There is no server cafe. Then server cafe people, they are not getting any good business, right?
Yes.
And at that time, the PCO, STD PCOs were very, very doing the very, very good business. Remember? STD PCOs,
yes.
ISD calls, STD calls.
Yes.
One. That was a time also. And the people were waiting in the queue. Now my turn will come for the call. STD call.
Yes.
Check the pressure. Now stop this script, close this script. This file, this DOS file, DOS, cmd.exe, close it. Okay, let's check the CPU utilization. It will gradually decrease. So it will also take the 5 minutes waiting time period, then automatically it will keep on deleting the extra machines. And how many machines you kept it as minimum machines? One or two?
So one.
One, okay. It's very good and cost saving.
Yes, sir.
So here we are in Microsoft Azure, we are calling as virtual machine scale set. The same thing in AWS, we are calling as auto scaling. If anybody will do the Azure course, if the person in future want to switch to the other cloud like AWS cloud or the Google cloud, it will be very easy to switch in the other cloud platform. Because the concept is same. Concept is same. But the steps will be vary. Means the number of steps will be very different. Because there is a different technology. Different cloud technology. AWS is different. Google is different. Azure is different. Alibaba is different. Alibaba is also giving the 1 year subscription. Azure also should provide the 1 year subscription, just only providing 30 days free trial. See, deleting is progress.
Yes, so our 1 month trial will be finishing sometime soon, right?
Yeah. How many credit cards in your home?
I see 14,000 something. Yes. 13,900.
Okay. So I'm asking, once it will be finished, you have to create the another account. And you require the another credit card then.
Oh, okay.
Maybe this is yours credit card. Maybe you can ask to your wife or any other family member for the second credit card.
I guess Azure also started 1 year subscription, right? I found it somewhere. Like I was
actually reading. Subscription is worth for the 1 year. Subscription is still for the 1 year, 12 months, right?
Mm-hmm.
But whatever the credit they are giving you, it will be expired after the 30 days.
Oh,
your account, Azure account will not be closed. It will be continued for the 12 months.
Okay.
But only the basics things will be there. Whatever the virtual machine you can create it, storage account you can create, all these store resources or the credit related things will be stopped after the 30 days.
Got it. Yeah. So I guess it's been more than 30 days now because we started on 23rd of July.
Then how 13? How many days are remaining to expire this trial? Your trial account?
Yeah, let me check it.
Yeah. So your free credit is still remaining 12,815. Yeah, utilization is very less. That's good.
Enjoying the freebies.
Yeah. So later, if you want to convert as a pay as you go, you can click over the click here to upgrade to pay as you go. Pay as you go means how much you will use, you have to pay that much. So it will never expire. It will never expire.
Okay, then. Luckily today is the last day actually.
Today? Oh my God. So at least you did the practical of SAS virtual machine skill set.
Yep.
Okay. Just refresh it. Oh, that's nice. Very nice. So all okay. One minimum word virtual machine you kept it, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. It will get deleted. Okay. So now you can unshare your screen. Okay. So guys, we have to delete our resources. So I will delete my resource group. So better to delete the resource group directly instead of deleting the each and every resource individually. So this is my resource group with the name test. So select the resource group test, click over delete resource group. And we need to type test, click on delete. So deletion will be happen in the cloud, because the deletion is working on the cloud. It is processing on the cloud. Even we will shut down the computer also, still the deletion process will be there. Okay guys, that's it for today. So we will meet on Tuesday, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And okay, that's it. So assignment you have done already today. Okay, I will give you one assignment for the homework. Okay, that you can do it. The assignment homework is homework assignment. Is the, let's say this is VNet 1. VNet 2, VNet 3, and these are the three VNets. VNet A, VNet B, VNet C, and the VNet A 10.0.0.0/16. VNet B must have 20.0.0.0/16. VNet C must have 30.0.0.0/16. This must be the range of the network. And in the VNet A, there is one subnet. In the VNet B, there must be some subnet. And in the VNet C, there must be some subnet. Subnet A. Subnet B, subnet A network range 10.0.0.0/24. Subnet B network range, here subnet B 20.0.0.0/24. Subnet C 30.0.0.0/24. So here in the subnet A, you have to create two virtual machines. In the subnet B, you have to create two virtual machines. Okay, create one. Okay, that's it. One virtual machine. And all of the virtual machines should be able to communicate with each other. That is your assignment. Okay. And you know how you can do it. You have to create the VNet peering. You need to create the peering in between all the VNets. Got it? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So this will be your assignment. Okay. You have to do the peering in between all the VNets. And then you will be able to communicate all these virtual machines. So this will be your homework assignment. You can send it to me once you will complete.
Okay, sir.
Okay, guys. Bye-bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Bye.